Welcome to The Ambassador, a prophetic teaching ministry designed to help win the nations and equip the saints. And now, join Craig DeMeau with his special guest.
Well, God bless you, and thank you for joining us for the midweek broadcast. I'm Craig DeMeau, and I'm so happy to have with us all of this week Pastor Chris Schauermann. He's been a real blessing to this audience, and this hasn't been the first time, but I'm glad you're here listening to us right now. I know that what he's got to share today will be a real blessing to you, whether the specific issue he'll address is something that affects you personally or somebody you know and love. Praise God. Pastor Chris, thanks for being with us again.
Thank you for having me, Craig.
Amen. Well, it's a real blessing. Thank the Lord. And I just, in case we don't get an opportunity to mention this a little bit later, we are making available this week his book, Wellness Gospel, a Scriptural Guide to Healthcare. And today, you promised you would talk about birth defects, praise God, birth defects. And there's so many different kinds of them. And I'd like for you to just launch into that big subject. And we only have, of course, a few minutes to do this. But just get into that a little bit and just talk about this and why it's so important.
Well, it's on the rise. I mean, things are getting worse and worse and worse as people get farther and farther away from a biblical plan of eating and living. Miscarriages are at an all-time high. Birth defects, autism. Autism used to be 1 in 10,000, and right now it's 1 in 88. Attention deficit hyperactivity, learning disabilities is at 13%, cancer in kids. My wife and I taught childbirth classes starting back almost 43 years ago for a local hospital, and she actually is the one who does most of the studying, and there found a doctor who had taken almost all of this away from his hospital to where they went from 33% of the women getting sick to nobody getting sick. And they basically asked the women to do two things. One, drink a quart of milk every day, and two, eat two eggs every day. Mm-hmm. Now, there's all kinds of people that say, oh, no, you shouldn't eat eggs. They're full of cholesterol. Well, eggs have lecithin in them that breaks down the cholesterol and makes it healthy. And God, when Jesus wanted to tell us about a really good gift, he was talking about the Holy Spirit. He said, if a son asked for an egg, would his father give him a scorpion? Well, if you know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will your Heavenly Father give you the Holy Spirit? So of all the examples he could give of a good gift being the Holy Spirit, the example he used was an egg. An egg is perfect protein. And if a woman gets two eggs and a quart of milk every day, she will not have birth defects, she won't have a stillbirth. It's just that simple.
Yeah. Amen. So, yeah, you know, so many of these things are coming up today, and people are dealing with all kinds of issues, and it causes such great consternation. And it's like, you know, we want to take millions of dollars and throw them at these studies on how to deal with things from an allopathic standpoint, rather than really get back to the basics of how God created the body. And it's unfortunate. So praise God.
Well, unfortunately, allopathy medicine is just finding some kind of a chemical that will get rid of your symptoms. Well, that doesn't help. It doesn't heal things. It doesn't make things right. It's like after the fact, when you're already sick, now we're going to make you not feel as sick as you were. No, what we want to be is not sick.
Right, right. So give us another example of a birth defect and what should be done while the mother is still pregnant.
Okay, so the Bible also says in Proverbs 23, verses 1 and 2, it says that we are to not eat the king's dainties. And it says, look at this food. It's not what it claims to be. It's deceptive food. It tastes really good. It looks really good, but it's bad for you. And when women are pregnant are eating lots of sugar, there's no nutrition there. So you have the baby's body is growing, but it's not getting the nutrition it needs. Babies are primarily made of calcium and protein. They have bones and they have muscle. And calcium, you get it from milk, and protein, you get from eggs. You have to give the baby what it needs so that it can build a healthy body, and it will.
Yeah. You know, God put innate intelligence in every human body. You know, it's amazing. Of course, he did that with every species. But you think about this, you know, you're the result of a sperm united with an egg, and you start as a one-celled organism, and your body grew itself all by itself. It had the intelligence to do that, and God programmed that into the human DNA. I mean, that's how
absolutely amazing
the body is, you know?
Amen. It's absolutely amazing. That it has all, that one cell has all of the information it needs to build a body.
Yeah, it's amazing. And it's not anything that science has ever been able to replicate or anything like that, and it's not going to happen because only God can do something that amazing. You know, the psalmist said, Psalm 139, that I'm fearfully and I'm wonderfully made, which, you know, that's an understatement, you know. But, I mean, how can you express that with your normal kind of tongue? Yeah, I guess you have to talk in tongues to really say it right. But at any rate, it's amazing what God has done. But see, if God has put this complex ecosystem in place, you know, I know that he has a way of being able to get to us what we need so the body can fix itself of certain problems. But when it comes to birth defects, these things we need to be on the front end of them. And so thank God for people like yourself, your wife, Sherry, who are educating young people about how to properly conceive and carry that baby and take care of things. So that like your experience with the hospital, you know, you went from, you know, a food being sick to none of them being sick. And that's just a result of good, godly, biblical education. And these things are all in your book, aren't they?
They're all in my book. And again, you know, we went from being sick and tired and having all these problems to not having any of these problems. We raised 13 kids. We didn't have health insurance because we never needed it. Our kids were healthy. And anyway, God's way is great.
Praise God. Well, we're just about out of time. But listen, I want to just say to everybody listening, you can't really argue with that kind of experience. So I encourage you in the strongest terms to get a hold of Wellness Gospel, a scriptural guide to health care, and you won't be sorry you did. Thanks so much for being with us again, Pastor Chris. And join us tomorrow.
We trust this program is a blessing to you. If you'd like to receive a CD copy of this week's broadcast, just let us know. And if you can, please include an offering with your request to help us with our radio expenses. To learn more, we recommend Pastor Chris Schauermann's insightful manual, God's Guide to Biblical Health and Healing. This guide covers every aspect of physical health from a biblical perspective. In 12 chapters, you'll find out what the Bible calls good food and bad food, the importance of your body, when to seek a doctor, overcoming depression, plus the role of bacteria, exercise, sleep, attitudes, and sin, all in addition to understanding God's laws of health, including the law of faith. Right now, we're making Chris Schauermann's manual available to you with your gift to this ministry of any size. Just contact Ambassador Ministries, P.O. Box 19561, Portland, Oregon 97280. That's Ambassador Ministries, P.O. Box 19561, Portland, Oregon 97280.
Now, a quick update on this manual. It was recently updated from 115 pages to 183 full-size pages, and it's now called Wellness Gospel, a Scriptural Guide to Healthcare. You'll definitely be glad you got a hold of this. It could even save your life. Now listen to this, then I'll be right back.
We're inviting you to the 6th Annual Ambassador Ministries Celebration Benefit Dinner. It's Saturday, March 2nd from 6 to 8 p.m. Due to a generous gift, your dinner is provided, but you must RSVP. You'll enjoy an unforgettable evening with heavenly worship, great fellowship, a fabulous meal, and good news from around the world. Don't miss out. And don't wait to reserve your place. Seating is limited. It's Saturday, March 2nd from 6 to 8 p.m. at the Rock Creek Country Club. Call now, 503-692-2900. That's 503-692-2900. See you there.
The celebration benefit dinner is right upon us. I sure hope I'll be seeing you there on Saturday, March 2nd. This is something that only happens once a year, and it's not your typical benefit. People learn a lot, they worship a lot, they fellowship around a great meal, and one thing I hear over and over from those who come is that they enjoy themselves a whole lot. You really ought to be there, so I hope you've given me your RSVP. If you haven't, do so. And if you have, let a friend know. If you call me right away, chances are we still have space. Now, we're so privileged to have Chris Schauermann with us, and I would love to know your standing with us so that programs like these can continue. We need the prayers and financial support of our partners and friends to stay on the air. We often talk about partnership. That's a term we hear a lot. But as you know, partnership is not just about finances. It's a biblical concept that refers to God's people working together for the advancement and enlargement of the kingdom of God. I want to ask you to just pray about partnership with this ministry, then do whatever God tells you to do. And remember that partnership is not necessarily a long-term commitment. It might just be a one-time gift to help us with a project or a missions outreach, or just to let us know that you're praying for us. If you do decide to help us on a monthly basis, that would mean a whole lot because monthly commitments form a foundation for us to operate. Now be sure to join me for the next broadcast. Until then, just remember, my friend, that you are God's ambassador. You're His representative on the earth. Bye for now.
You've been listening to The Ambassador with Craig DeMo. Your testimonies and prayer requests are very important to Craig. Please write Ambassador Ministries, P.O. Box 19561, Portland, Oregon 97280. This ministry is sustained by the faithfulness of God through our partners and friends. To find out more about partnering with the Lord through this exciting ministry, contact Ambassador Ministries, P.O. Box 19561, Portland, Oregon 97280. Our web address is ambassadorministries.us. That's ambassadorministries.us. May God richly bless you.